Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to study the topic binomial trees and binomial heaps. This is a topic from unit number 5 of the course Design and Analysis of Algorithms. So previously, we have already studied the concept of binary heaps. So on similar grounds, we are going to study binomial trees and binomial heaps. So these are the contents that we will be covering in this lecture. We will begin with the definition of binomial trees, followed by properties of binomial trees. Then we will study the concept of binomial heaps, that is the definition of binomial heap, followed by properties of binomial heap, and then we'll wind up with the representation of binomial heaps. So before we actually jump into the topic, let us understand what are the objectives and outcomes of this particular lecture. So the objective is to understand the concept of binomial trees and binomial heaps, and the outcome, that is after going through this lecture, you will be able to define the binomial trees, you will be able to explain the properties of binomial trees, you will be able to define binomial heaps, you will be able to explain the properties of binomial heaps, and you will be able to understand the representation of binomial heaps. So now let us begin. So first we will study what are binomial trees. So a binomial tree of order k is an ordered tree defined recursively as follows. So order 0, that is B0, binomial tree of order 0 consists of only a single node, that is it does not have any child node. Similarly, if you have a binomial tree of order k, that is bk, where k represents the order, it consists of two binomial trees bk minus 1 which are linked together. So what this property means is, let us say you have b2 binomial tree, so it means that it consists of two b1 trees which are linked together, that is bk minus 1 trees are linked together. So we'll see that with the help of example. So in this figure, you can see in the first part you have a single node, and this represents binomial tree of order 0, that is B0, which has a single node. Okay, so you can generalize this. If you have a binomial tree of order k, that is BK, it consists of two BK minus 1 trees which are linked together. Okay, so this represents binomial tree of order k in general, and this represents a B0 binomial tree which has a single node. Similarly, figure B shows different binomial trees from B0 to B4. B0 and B1 we have already seen. Now we'll move to B2. So B2 will consist of, as per the definition, two B minus 1 trees which are linked together. So two B1 trees, that is this is a B1 tree, this is a B1 tree. So these are the two B1 trees which are linked together in a B2 tree. Similarly, if it is a B3 binomial tree, that means it will consist of two B2 trees which are linked together. So you can see here in this is one B2 tree, this is another B2 tree, and these two B2 trees are linked together. Similarly is the case with B4. Okay. So now in this, in these binomial trees, you can see here 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. This represents nothing but level or the depth of the tree or the height of the tree. So you can see this particular node is a level 0 node. So its height is 0. These nodes are level 1, these nodes are level 2, these nodes are level 3, and this node is level 4. So if it is a B4 tree, then you can say that its height or depth is 4. Okay. Now we'll move to the properties of binomial trees. So in general, you say that if you are given with a BK or a K ordered binomial tree, then one thing that is very obvious is its height is K. So you can see that with the help of previous slide. So if you say B3, that means it indicates the height is 3. So K indicates nothing but the height or depth of the tree. So So if it is B4, then 4 represents the height or depth of the tree. So that is very obvious, K represents the height of the tree. Then second thing which is again very obvious is it has 2 raised to K nodes. So let us understand that also with the help of the previous example. So if you consider B0, that means value of K is 0. So the property says that it has 2 raised to K nodes. So if value of K is 0, 2 raised to 0 becomes 1. That is the reason zero order tree has a single node. Okay. Similarly is the case if you consider B3. In case of B3, value of K is 3. So it consists of 2 raised to K nodes. That is 2 raised to 3 nodes. So 2 raised to 3 is nothing but 8. So you can see here in this B3 tree, you can see there are total number of nodes is equal to 8. Okay, so that is what the second property means. Then you have a third property which is very interesting, is it has KCI nodes at depth I. Now you are able to understand this representation. Whenever you write something in this form, it means that KCI. So this representation indicates a binomial coefficient. So in our case, K is nothing but the height or the height of the tree, and I indicates the depth. So in this property, what we are trying to do is, let us say value of K is 4, that means it is a B4 tree for example, and we want to find out how many nodes are there in that binomial tree at depth I. Let us say I is equal to 2. So let us understand this property with the help of example. So again let us consider B3, okay, or let us consider B4, okay, K is equal to 4. So let's say I want to find out how many nodes are there at level 2, okay, or at depth 2. So in that case, value of I becomes 2 and value of K is 4. So if you put that up in the representation KCI, if you evaluate that, that is if you evaluate 4C2, the value comes out to be 6. So you can see here at this level in the tree B4, total number of nodes that you get is 6. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so that is what the property means. So at any particular level, if you want to find out how many nodes are there in that tree at a particular level, you can use the property. Then you come to the fourth property, the degree of its root is k. Again, this is analogous to the first one, the degree of its root is k. So if it is a B4 tree, then you can say that the root node has degree k, or the root node has degree 4 if it is a B4 tree. Okay. Then the last property is deleting the root node yields k binomial trees. That also we will study with the help of example. Let us say we are considering B4 and we delete the root node. So if you are deleting this node from here, let us see how many binomial trees it generates. So this node is deleted. So this now remains only a B0 tree. So this is a B0 tree. This is a B1 tree. This is a B2 tree. And this is a B3 tree. Okay. So you can see here, if it is a B4 or 4 ordered binomial tree, and if you are deleting the root node, you get B3 tree, B2 tree, B1 tree and a B0 tree. So that is what the property indicates. So these are the different properties of a binomial tree. Next we move on to the concept of binomial heap. So what is a binomial heap? Having studied the concept of binomial trees before, binomial heap is nothing but it is a sequence of, or it is a combination of, or it is a collection of binomial trees such that each tree in a binomial heap is heap ordered. Now here when we say heap ordered, we are actually referring to a min heap, that is the root node has the minimum value. Then next property is, there can only be at most one binomial tree for each order, including zero order. Now, in order to understand this property, the second property, let us see one example. For example, n is equal to 13, which indicates the binomial heap consists of total 13 nodes. Okay, so the property says that in any binomial heap, you can have a number of binomial trees, but there will be only one binomial tree of each order. That is, you can only have one B0 tree, you can only have one B1 tree, you can only have one B2 tree, and so on so forth. Okay, so if n is equal to 13, I want to find out how many binomial trees are there and what is the order of each of these binomial trees in this binomial heap which consists of 13 nodes. So how to do that? First step is n is equal to 13, so you have to find out the binary representation of 13, which is 1101. What we have to do next is, from this binary representation, we have to only consider the non-zero bits. So let us say the first non-zero bit, that is the LSB, is 1. Okay, so this represents 2 raised to 0. Then this bit is 0, so we ignore. Next non-zero bit is this, which is nothing but 2 raised to 2. And then the last non-zero bit is this, which represents 2 raised to 3. So if you add these, you get the value 13. Okay. Now what this represents is nothing but order of the binary tree. We have already seen that binary tree, the total number of nodes in the in the tree is represented as 2 raised to k. Okay. So 2 raised to 0 represents a 0 ordered binomial tree, 2 raised to 2 represents order 2 binomial tree, and 2 raised to 3 represents order 3 binomial tree. So this clearly indicates that n determines total number of binomial trees in a binomial heap, and n also determines the order of each of these binomial trees. Okay, so from this example we can conclude for a binomial heap with 13 nodes, it will consist of 3 binomial trees of order 3, 2 and 0. So in this way you can determine how many binomial trees will be there and what will be the order of each of these binomial trees. Now one question that is obviously it might come to your mind is, why we are studying this binomial heaps? So in the previous lectures we have already seen that if you want to perform the merging or union operation, then it is a very costly affair. So if you are using binomial heaps, then this merging or union operation can be performed in logarithmic time, which we will be studying in the subsequent lectures. So for that purpose we are using binomial heaps. So this was about the property of binomial heap. Now we move on to the representation of binomial heap. So let us say this is a binomial heap where this is the head and it is pointing to this node 10. Now it is a single node, that means it is obvious it is a order 0 binomial tree, which is then linked to the next binomial tree. You can see this is order 2 binomial tree, and then which is linked to the next binomial tree, which is an order 3 binomial tree. So we will now study how to represent this. So it is represented in this fashion, where the first part represents a pointer to the parent. Okay, second part represents the key value, third part represents the degree of that particular binomial tree, and the fourth part represents pointer to the left and to the right child. So as you can see from this, you have 3 binomial trees, one with value 10, one with value 1, one with value 6. The degree of the first binomial tree is 0, of the second binomial tree is 2, and of the third binomial tree is 3. So that is represented in this fashion. Degree here is 0, degree for 1 is 2, and degree for the last binomial tree is 3. Okay, and the value is 10, 1 and 6 respectively, and all these are root nodes. That is why the parent there is no pointer to the parent, that is why this is null. Okay, then you have the first binomial tree was order 0, that is it does not have any children. Similarly, the second one is order 2, so it has a left child, it has a right child. So the left child is having value 12 and it is an order 1 tree, that is why 1 here, and it is linked to the value 18, and this is order 0 binomial tree, that is why here 0. Similarly, this is having value 25 and it is an order 0 tree, that is why 0 here, and it does not have any left and right child, so null here. Okay, so this is how you represent B2. Similarly, B3 is represented in the same way, where 6 is having children 8, 14 and 29. 8 is order 2 binomial tree, 14 is order 1 binomial tree and 29 is order 0. Okay, so since 18 is order 2, it is linked to 11 and 17, each with order 1 and 0. Similarly, 14 is order 1, so it is linked to 38 with order 0. Okay, similarly here 11 with order 1 is linked to 28 with order 0. So this is the representation of binomial heap. So in this lecture we have covered the binomial trees and binomial heaps. We started with the definition of binomial trees, followed by properties of binomial trees, and then we have seen the definition of binomial heap, properties of binomial heap, followed by the representation of binomial heap. So I hope you have understood the concept. In case you have any doubts, you can mail it to me on ngsharma@kkmark.edu.in. Thank you so much for your patient listening.